So now I really went to art school. Thanks, Annie, for the grease drawing. So what does it take to make a network like this work? So let's suppose we wanted to send a message from Rhodes to Sparta. And we have many points along the way where we can send smoke signals. So we'd start by sending a smoke signal from Rhodes. This would be visible from a few other points. And to reach Sparta, the one at Nachos would need to resend it. We'd need to also submit a smoke signal that would be visible at some other points. The one at Melos would need to see it and resend it. And maybe that's already visible at Sparta. So we need several different things in order to make a network like this work. The first thing we need is a way to encode messages. We need to be able to convert the message that we want to send. Say it's a message that says the Trojans are arriving. We need to be able to send that message and encode that in a smoke signal. We need a way to do routing. We need to figure out where the message should go. If we want to send it to Sparta, we need to know that it should be forwarded by these nodes. The node that sees it from Miletus does not need to resend it. Probably the way the ancient Greek network worked, all the nodes resent every message. They didn't have a way to do routing selectively, but that's very wasteful. What we'd like is a way to only send the message to the destination it goes to. For the kinds of messages the ancient Greeks were sending that says things like the enemy's arriving, well, it was okay. You wanted to send it everywhere. That's called flooding the network. But if we want to send messages just between two points, we've got to know which nodes should resend the message or which direction to send it in. And the final thing we need to worry about is we need to decide who gets to use the network. So it might be that there are more than one enemy arriving at once, or maybe the enemy is arriving. It might be at the same time Achilles, say Achilles is in Miletus, and he wants to send a message back to Medea in Delphi. So maybe Achilles wants to send a message that would go like this at the same time as the army needing to send this important message that's saying the Trojans are arriving. So we need to figure out who gets to use the network and what they get to send. So these are all things the ancient Greek network would have had to deal with if it was sophisticated enough to worry about them. If it was just sending the message that says the troops are arriving, well, that's one smoke signal and it didn't necessarily need that. All of these are the same things that we need to worry about if we want to send messages on the internet. So these are the things that we need to make any network. We need some way to take the messages that we want to send and encode them in a way that they can be transmitted and interpret them when they get to the other end. For the Greeks, the message was something like Agamemnon is arriving, get the ships to a safe place. And they needed to encode that in a smoke signal. We need a way to route messages. We need a way for the receiver of the smoke signal to know the next place to send it. And for the ancient Greek network, since smoke signals are not directional, they just go up in the air, there wasn't much to do here. Everyone could see the message and they wanted to send the message everywhere. If we want to send messages just between two points, this becomes a much tougher problem. We need rules for deciding who gets to use resources. If there are two messages that want to go through the same place, well, only one of those can be sent at a time. We need some way to decide what. For the Greeks, well, I don't know what their rules were, but let's assume their rule was, if you're a general, your message has priority. We're going to need all these same things for the internet. Before we talk about how they're done on the internet, I want to introduce the two main ways that we measure networks.